let's talk about work habits and this idea of the four-day work week.
Yeah, well, I think this is one where in Canada, we're going to have to wait and see how things shake out. And it's often, I think, going to play out potentially on a company by company basis. It's up to employers, unless there's major changes happening on the legislation front, it's up to employers to test the waters, see what happens to production if the things are scaled back from 5 to 4 or hours are reduced. In some cases, the drop-off in activity might not be too much. And so that will allow things to move around, be it if employees are working at times when activity isn't particularly strong, or potentially, you know, if employees are less burnt out by excessive work weeks, that could mean productivity gains concentrated in those squeezed in times. But it's really going to depend business to business, because the way many areas of the economy operate right now, there's a kind of tried and true method. And so it's up to businesses and workers to experiment with different options to see what works best.
You've undoubtedly heard of the trend emerging in the summer of 2021, quitting.
Mm-hmm. And this is an area where in Canada, our line of sight into this trend is a bit challenged. That said, in the US, there's a survey which I like to track called the JOLTS, the Job Opening and Labor Turnover Survey, which tracks how many employees voluntarily quit every month. And what we saw was a drop off early in the pandemic and now a steep rise more recently. And so I think this could be reflecting a bunch of different things. In one sense, there's a potential for catch up in activity, that kind of life went on pause in the spring of 2020 and in the summer. And now people are kind of getting back to what they were going to do previously before their plans were all halted. And so that could be resulting in people changing careers, changing employers. And then we also have a question about just a tightening labor market and the opportunity for workers to transition from employer to employer because there are better job opportunities and because employers who are looking to hire might be under pressure to actually sweeten the deal to attract workers. And so I think these are trends that we're seeing in the US. Canada, it's a bit tougher to track. We don't have a publicly available quit rate like the US does, but an interesting trend, and one that, especially if opportunities for workers are strong, we see job postings on Indeed well above their pre-pandemic levels now, that gives workers the confidence to find something new, find something potentially better paying, better location, all the things workers care about have potential to be in more supply if the job market is getting tighter.